Hi everyone. Today we are very happy to have John Brus, the co-founder of the Molen Brewery and also Kaapse Brewery, right?
Yes, that's correct. Yeah.
So today we are going to talk about some questions that some Chinese home brewers are very interested with, in. Mm-hmm. So now we'll just start with the craft beer movement in the Netherlands.
Yeah.
So could you introduce a little bit about how the craft beer has developed in the Netherlands?
A little bit, I can tell you. Yeah. I can talk for 2 hours.
Yeah.
Well, to be very short, there used to be a lot of breweries in Holland many years ago. A city like Delft, where we are now, used to have like 25 or even more breweries. But this is a long time ago, and then at one point bigger breweries evolved somehow, and they killed all the small breweries. And this was finalized, I think, in the 80s, when Holland only had maybe 20 breweries. But at that point, people started discovering Belgian beers, because this had not happened in Belgium.
Why?
Probably because Belgian people are more, how do you call that, more
conservative?
Conservative, yeah, okay. maybe conservative, yeah. Or chauvinism. No, they like what's in the neighborhood or in their region. Yeah. If there's a brewery, they like that brewery, they drink that beer.
Oh. So they always keep their tradition.
Yeah, they keep the tradition,
the
and we didn't.
Yes.
Okay. So you mean Dutch people are more creative?
No, they are not. They are not creative. Well, they are creative, but that's not the reason.
Yeah.
It's more because they are indeed conservative, mm-hmm. And they keep. But Holland started to discover. People in Holland started to discover this beer, and so it became the first new microbreweries in Holland, like at Eij, for example, in Amsterdam, making Belgian style beers. So, and this was going on since the late 80s, early 90s, and kept continuing this way. And then in the zeros, just in the start of this century, a few people started discovering the craft beers that were brewed in America, in Italy, and especially in Scandinavia. Yeah. And a small group of beer lovers, beer geeks, how you want to call them, they started to drink those beers. Mm-hmm. And actually, we were one of the first to adapt to the change in beer styles. Yeah. And we started brewing beers we really liked, like English strong ale, like a stout, and later on imperial stout, stuff like that. And for the first few years, until maybe 2-3 years ago, there were only a few brewers doing this in Holland, like barrel aging, imperial stouts or barley wines. We were the first to do that, I think, and some followed. Yeah. And now, 2 years ago, suddenly a wider range of people started discovering craft beer, IPAs, double IPAs, saison, sour ales, whatever. Yeah. Sour ales not that much yet, but it will come, believe me. And this exploded. And also, I think a part of this happened because of the crisis.
Yeah.
Because you would expect people don't have money to buy special beers, strong, expensive beers. Mm. But what they did, they made their own beer. And then discovered, they started homebrewing, and then they lost their job.
Oh.
I thought, you know what, I can brew, well, let's start brewing.
Yeah.
So we went from maybe 125 brewers to 250 brewers in 2 years' time.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
You mean nowadays you have 250?
At now at the moment we have 250, 260 brewers.
Registered? Oh.
Yes.
So you didn't count all of the home brewers?
No, just registered brewers who are selling. Some of them brewing only small batches, like 300 liters, 500 liters, once a week. Some of them, like us, who do a little bit more than that. And it's growing fast. And also people like craft beer. It's growing very fast at the moment.
Okay. So John, Because you see, Netherlands is actually surrounded by, you know, North Europe, the four countries, and then Germany and Belgium. And do you think your beer is influenced more by European countries or by America?
Do you mean out the Molen?
Yeah,
or
the Molen.
The Dutch brewers?
Yeah, or new Dutch brewers.
Yeah, well, most of them are influenced by either Belgian style or American style beers. So the very hoppy IPAs.
Hoppy.
The West Coast or East Coast IPAs, American beers.
Okay.
Or Belgian style still. A lot of new brewers, they make Belgian style beers, like a blonde, a triple.
Traditional
Belgian style beers.
Okay.
Yeah. So this is there are a few, but there's only little that are influenced by German beers, by German style beers.
Because German, I think they keep their tradition even a long time ago.
They have their law, right?
Yeah, they have special law.
Yes,
so,
they do have the Reinheitsgebot, but the purity law in English.
Yes. Yeah.
But the beers are not bad, but they are dull.
Yeah.
You know, they're not very interesting. You can drink them in large glasses and enjoy them, but it's different from something like this.
You know that in China, most of the beer drinkers, they start from German beers because they are most famous in China.
Yes, all over the world, I think.
Yeah.
German and Czech beers like Pilsner or
it's kind of a lager.
Pale lager.
Pale lagers or Dunkel and Weizen. So wheat ale. It's very popular all over the world, I think.
Yeah.
So, a special question for De Molen. So, how can you distinguish yourself if you compare with your other, let's say, brewers in Netherlands? What makes you special?
What makes us special is very hard to say, of course. First of all, we aim for quality. That's one of our that's our policy. Mm-hmm. We don't care about the price of ingredients.
Yeah.
We want the best hops. We want the best malts, we experiment a lot. Mm-hmm. So that's what we do in the beer itself. Secondly, we were one of the first to start with this, so we already have a name, and are ahead of the troops. You know, so that distinguishes us as well, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Besides that, it's just for us, it's we love beer. You know, we are very passionate about beer.
Yeah, sure.
We wake up with beer in our minds. We go to work with on my way to the work in my car, beer, this beer, and then we brew all day, and then we go home and I get to my wife and she says, "How was your day?" "Well, you know," and I talk about beer.
Okay.
So
this
is one of our things. We are very passionate about beer. We love good beer and good people.
Be careful when you're driving your car. Never drink a beer when you're driving. So.
No, I'm not drinking and driving. I'm thinking about beer.
Okay, that's nice.
Yeah, just a small sample. I was in Germany and there was one with us who has nothing to do with beer. Okay. And we were sitting there just drinking beer, whatever. But she said, afterwards she said, "I was so surprised. But normally when I go somewhere with guys, they get the beer, they open the bottle, or they have a glass of beer, they drink and they talk about cars. You guys, you get the beer, you sit down, you smell, you look, you judge, you taste, it's all about the beer." Yes, it's all about
maybe the beer. Because, you know, in Germany beer is very cheap, so they just drink beer like water for your system.
For
they count your large quantity, right?
Yes,
so that's
at some street they have this very high tube they drink from.
Or the big glasses.
Yes.
Looks like a boot.
Boot, yes.
Yeah. Oh, okay, yeah. So I think our beer is more like craft beer.
Yeah.
So we pay a lot of attention in the brewing process. It's expensive, but the quality is also much better.
Yes, it's absolutely. And we share a lot of information with other brewers.
Okay.
If you look at the big brewers, they hate each other. If you look at craft beer brewers, they visit each other, they talk about beer, they brew together.
And
that's very different. Also, you know, a lot of times we get a call, "Hey, I'm, I don't know, Emeliso or another Dutch brewer.
Cool.
I need this kind of hop. Do you have it? Yeah, sure. I will send it to you. No, that's why we work. We're not
for free.
We're colleagues. not for free, but it's not like we're paying 100 euros for a kilo of hops. The normal price we pay as well.
Yeah. Okay, that's nice. And my question is, you export most of your beer, right?
Yes, at the moment about 70%.
Yes. So what's your marketing strategy about this?
We have no strategy. It's just somebody wants our beer, and if we have it, we sell it. You know,
okay.
It's very hard to make a strategy if you can't brew enough beer, because the demand is higher than we can produce.
Yeah, yeah.
But we are increasing. That's a strategy. We are really increasing our production at the moment.
Yeah.
We have done in the past. How do you call it? Five times the amount of beer we did 4 years ago.
Yeah.
And we want to increase another five times in the coming 3 years.
Wow.
So that's what we are doing. And we have some sort of strategy, because lately we have not been focusing on Holland itself. We have been exporting beer a lot. But now we're trying to focus on Belgium and Holland. And France first, and then decide what to do after that.
Yeah, because I go to a local supermarket like a Jumbo or Abraham, I cannot find the one beer in there. But I went to Wageningen, you know?
Wageningen.
Their supermarket has a lot of the modern beers.
Okay.
So I was astonished, you know, surprised. Yeah.
I didn't know that myself.
I think it depends on the flavor of the manager.
The taste of the manager of the
supermarket.
Absolutely.
If
you like, you can buy beer from you and we can buy from the supermarket.
Yes.
Okay, well then I have a surprise for you, because starting this week, Albert Heijn, biggest supermarket chain in Holland, will start with two of our beers.
Oh, cool. You mean every...
No, just in two provinces. In South Holland and Zeeland.
So we can buy it in Delft now?
It's even in the Gorsterhout. You know, there they also have just two beers. Op en Top and Mooi met Oogloos.
Oh,
so
that's cool.
Op en Top? Oh, I know that beer. Yeah. And Fire and Flame?
No, Mooi met Oogloos.
Oh, Mooi?
It's an Imperial style.
Imperial style. Oh, okay.
Yeah. And they will probably add a third one in a couple of weeks, and that will be a new beer called Hop en Liefde. So that's like hop and love.
Okay.
If you translate that.
Cool.
Do
you know the, for example, do you know in the supermarket how much will the for the Imperial start? Normally this beer is very expensive.
I don't know, because this beer was not sold directly to them.
Via a
big distributor, so I'm not sure, but this will change. This will change in the near future. Yeah.
Because normally for your beer, if it's imported to China, it can be really expensive.
Yes.
Yeah. It's not double or triple. Yeah.
yeah. I can imagine. Okay.
So
it's also hard to export to China.
Yeah. So now I think De Molen has been, I think, ranked in many top 10s in the world brewery. And it only happened, I think, in less than 10 years. From
5 years, maybe?
10 years.
Yes, we started
Menno,
in 2004.
Menno
Menno started the brewery in 2004.
Yeah.
I joined him in 2009.
Okay.
And now we're exporting to about 30 countries.
30, yes.
And we love it that we are indeed ranked high on websites like greatbeer.com or
for sure that's because of your quality.
Yeah, I hope so.